Hello and welcome to my channel, Happy Learning to You, your ultimate guide to easy learning. So continuing with the topic of genetics, the chapter of principles of inheritance and variation, today I am going to explain about the concept of dominance. Let's begin. Now, what do you mean by dominance? Why are that some alleles are dominant and some alleles as recessive? Now to understand this, let's first see what a gene does. Well, every gene, it contains the information which is required to express a particular trait or a particular character. As in the human beings, the gene contains information for the hair color, the hair texture, skin color, the height and other characteristics. Now in diploid organisms, the human beings are also diploid. There are two copies of each gene, that is, a gene exists as a pair of alleles. So the two copies of each gene is known as alleles. Now these two alleles may either be identical, wherein they are known as homozygous, or they may be non-identical, wherein they are known as heterozygous. Now this difference in the two alleles may be due to some changes that the gene has undergone, which will modify the information that it carries. So because of certain modification in the information that is carried by the gene, the two alleles may be different from each other. So now let's take an example of a gene which contains information for producing an enzyme. Now the two allelic forms of this gene is the normal allele, which will produce a normal enzyme that is needed for the transformation of a substrate, say S. Now this is just an example. And the second allele is the modified allele. Now this allele is modified, so it may be responsible for the production of a normal allele, but which is less efficient, which will produce a less efficient enzyme, or it may produce a non-functional enzyme, or it may not produce an enzyme at all. So because of the modification of this allele, it may be responsible for producing any one type of an enzyme. So now let's concentrate on this modified allele. Now, in case the modified allele produces a normal enzyme but which is less efficient, then the modified allele is equivalent to the unmodified allele. Now this unmodified allele is the normal allele. So although it is less efficient, this enzyme is still a normal enzyme. So it will produce the same phenotype or the trait which would have been produced by a normal enzyme. Okay, and ultimately it will result in the transformation of the substrate S, okay, because it is its function. So it is capable of carrying out its function, which is transformation of the substrate S, although its efficiency is less. Now, in case this modified allele produces a non-functional enzyme or does not produce an enzyme at all, then in that case, the phenotype or the trait is dependent solely on the functioning of the unmodified, that is the normal allele. So in such case, this unmodified or the normal allele becomes the dominant allele and the modified allele will become the recessive allele. So this is a very short topic I had today. In my next video, I will explain about codominance. Thanks for watching and do subscribe to my channel for more such videos. Thank you.